I've finished spraying the chairs, and just for a bit extra, I'm going to make some chair bunting for the bench, just to go along the back of the bench, just because it's pretty and it'll cheer the garden up. So I'm going to do that now. So you just get a piece of cardboard, draw a triangle, so find the middle of a piece of card. And just draw a triangle. That'll be my template. So I'm just going to go through my bags of fabric scraps and get an assortment out. Actually, I've just found these. Oh, this brings back memories. This was my little girl's bedroom when she was little, probably 10 years ago, and oh, it was lovely. So I'd like to do it just in this, but I don't think I've got enough fabric, unless I just use the coloured fabric to back it, and then it could be double-sided. So yeah, so I'm gonna have the spots and stripes on one side, and then when it flips over, I'm gonna use these other bits to back it. That's what I shall do. So now, before I cut them out, I'm gonna have to iron the fabric. It's all creased. Okay, I'm actually going to do this on the ironing board because I think you'll be able to see better. This is the main fabric I want to use, and I haven't got much of this. I've only got this tiny piece, so I'm going to have to try and get as many triangles out of it as I can. So you just get your fabric, put your template on, and then draw around it. I can't find my tailor's chalk, so I'm just going to use a pencil, which is fine. I'll just do it on the wrong side. Okay, can you see? I've drawn, no, you can't see. I've drawn the triangles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, I've managed to get 10. Out of this, so if they're, oh, they're 4 inches, oh, so that's 40, oh, so I've done too many, because I measured the bench, that was 40 inches, so I actually only needed 5, didn't I, if I'm having 5 and 5, oh well, never mind, I'm going to cut them out, and maybe I can back them. Yeah, I don't need to use the other fabric. Actually, I should have cut these out a bit bigger to allow for the seam. No, I won't. I'll explain in a minute. No, what I'll do, I'll just zigzag the edges. That's what I will do. That'll be easier. Mind you, it'll take longer. So now I've just got to cut out all my triangles. I was just looking around the kitchen for all my bunting, and I realise I haven't got any now since I've redone the kitchen. In the old kitchen I had bunting over the windows, I had it between the light fittings, over the kitchen units. I loved it. I miss it, but I wanted this kitchen to be a bit more sophisticated, a bit less shabby chic, so I got rid of the bunting. So I can't show you one that's going to be probably made a bit better than this is going to be. This, I'm doing it quick, it's only for the garden. This would be a really nice thing to do with your kids, actually. If they were bored, because it's so easy. And if you didn't want to sew, you could always glue the pieces together. You could do it with paper, I suppose. Oh no, you couldn't, because then if it rains, it's had it. Okay, that's that. So now, in fact, just to make it quicker, I'm just gonna cut round one of these. In fact, this is quite a good idea to do it this way, because if your cutting's not very accurate, then you can, it doesn't matter if they're not the exact shape, you've just got a perfect front and back. So we'll do it that way. So I'm going to use the wrong side of this fabric, right side facing up. And you can put it right on the edge, which saves you another little job, so that you don't even have to cut down that side now. Okay, they're all cut out. What was I going to say? If you were doing this really, if you wanted to make a really nice job, say you were doing it for a child's bedroom or your kitchen, what you would do is you would sew, you'd put the wrong sides together, you would sew a tiny seam, then you would fold it inside out so that, I'll just do it quickly with one thing. Okay, so if you were doing it nicely, you would sew this, a little line of stitching down. You would fold it the right way, inside out, and then you'd have a nice, neat edge. Can you see that? But I'm not doing that. If you were doing that, you would have to make the template bigger than the finished size, because obviously you're taking away some of the fabric in the seam. But I'm not doing it like that, because it's only for the garden and I just want to do it quickly. And also, if you wanted to do it really quickly, or you didn't have a sewing machine, it doesn't have to be double-sided, and you could maybe buy some, I haven't got any pinking shears. I got interrupted and I can't remember what I was saying. I think I showed you, like, if you were doing it nicely, you would, you would do the seam, but you'd have to cut the template, you'd have to make it a bit bigger because you lose material all around the edge. But I'm doing, I'm just going to do it very rough. I'm just going to do a zigzag on all the raw edges. If you didn't have a sewing machine, or you just wanted to do it with small children, you could get some pinking shears. So they're the scissors that make a nice zigzag edge, and you wouldn't have double thickness. You'd just cut the triangle with the pinking shears. So now I'm gonna sew. Okay, now I'm just going to do a zigzag on the raw edges. I can't remember the last time I made anything. So relaxing. The nice thing about sewing and doing just bits is, maybe not sewing, maybe what I mean is, the nice thing about making things yourself is no one else has got it. And And like this fabric, oh, this is making me sad because I remember when I did my little girl's bedroom. I think it was when she'd went into a bed from a cot, and so we changed it from being a baby room to a little girl's room. And she had these curtains and pelmet and dressing table. And I'd forgotten all about it until I saw this fabric today. And it'd be really nice seeing it in the garden. And I'd be like, oh, that was her old room. It's sweet. You could cut up if you've got a favourite duvet and you've decorated your room and it doesn't go anymore, but you still like it. Make it out of something like that, or maybe your kids' clothes. If there's been clothes that you've really loved that they've grown out of, you can cut them up and make bunting out of them to remember how lovely they were when they were little and not bratty teenagers that hate you. Machine light keeps going on and off. Okay, I have finished all my little triangles now. So I'm just going to trim the thread off and lay them out on the ironing board. Okay, so I've finished the sewing, so now I need five this way and five the spotty way, and I'm just going to lay them out. Can you see? So now I need some ribbon or string or something to put them all together. So this is, oh, that's pretty, but it feels like it's paper. Weird stuff. Oh, it's peel off. Well, I don't know what you would use that for, but I can't use it for this. Not this. Oh, this is quite nice, this green. Oh, it's not long enough. Ah, there. I've got more. Yes. Oh, in fact, that's perfect. Then I can cut that in half and make little ties for the end. Yes, I'm going to use the green. So what I will do is just so I'm just gonna pin this on and then quickly sew it. Cut that in half so that you've got a little tie at the end to tie it round whatever you want, because that's the thing with shop bunting. They never have this and it's really annoying because you never know how to tie it. So just do two bits at the end. Like that. I think this would be such a sweet thing to do with like small children, to get them off the computers and the tablets. I always used to do things like this with my girls. Mind you, they haven't carried it on as they've got older, but we did do things like this when they were little. It's nice, and my mum did with me, and that's how come I know what to do. Not that this is exactly taxing, but it definitely gave me an interest. And again, put the extra tie at the other end. Okay, let's sew this together. I'm just going to use a straight stitch for this, not the zigzag. And don't forget to reverse it at the ends, because if it's going to tear anywhere, it will be there. And off we go. were doing this with your kids, you could make heart-shaped bunting or fairies or dinosaurs. You need a simple shape. If it's really complicated, it'd be far too difficult. So you could maybe get a cookie cutter and draw around a cookie cutter. Oh, that's a hard thing to say. Cookie cutter. Machine's jammed, never mind. There we are. I shall go and put it on the bench. So I've finished spraying, everything's dried. This is the bench, I'm really pleased with it. All it needs now are a couple of pretty cushions and the bunting that I finished. So I shall just pop that on. I'm not sure where the chairs are going yet, but I'll just put them here for now just to show you, but I'll put them around the garden somewhere. I think my bunting was a bit long, so Maybe I'll just fiddle with that. But I am pleased with it. I think it looks really pretty.